Hello, this is Travis Sabin with Adobe Analytics Product Management. And today in this video, I'm going to walk you through the updates to our new landing page. So we've taken a lot of the feedback we received from so many of our users. So thank you for that. And we've provided a bunch of changes and updates to the landing page experience here. One of the first things we've done is we have brought back the create new modal. So instead of it being a drop down like before, we've now brought the modal back. On the modal, you will see any of your company provided templates, as well as the blank project and blank mobile scorecard. Adobe templates are still listed and categorized within the reports menu and under the pre-canned reports there, but any company templates are here, and as well as the option to pick a blank project or mobile scorecard. Another thing that we've done based on some feedback is users wanted the option to rearrange these pins without unpinning all of them and then repinning them. So to adjust the order, we've simply added an option to move a project up or down in the list. So anything that is pinned, you can click on it with the ellipses and you can move it up. Or if you want, you can move it down. So that makes it much easier and convenient to organize any of your projects that you have pinned. Another great thing that we've added is the option to maximize more space here on the table. So in order to do that, we've provided this new hamburger menu where you can click on it to collapse or expand the three tabs on the side. So by collapsing that, you get a little bit more real estate here in the table. If you know that you want to stay here in the projects, obviously you can also collapse that little header there, which that was there before, but some great things to maximize the spacing here. Another thing that we've done, which was a huge request from a lot of people, was to make it so you can customize the widths of these columns. So before they were fixed, but now if you have a column that has, let's say, has a long header here, you can expand the name column. You can reduce the size of other columns. So if you want to, you can customize the widths of the columns here to allow for more readability and intuitiveness on reading exactly what you're looking at. So I know that was a big request by a lot of people. And next, I wanted to highlight some new columns that we've added. So first, we have some that are more for performance. So we have a project ID column and a longest date range column over here. And then finally, we have number of queries. So all of these can be helpful in debugging or identifying projects that could be a little bit slow based on the length of the date range or the number of queries that the project possesses. And then the last column that we've added is scheduled. Many people wanted to see if a project had a schedule associated with it here directly on the page. So we've added this column, and any project that has a schedule, as you can see, has a little green dot with on. If it does not, it's gray with off. Now those that do have a project scheduled, you can see that the on is clickable. It'll open up a modal, which will give you the scheduled project details. And the great thing is you can even edit that schedule directly from here, so you don't have to go anywhere else. So you can do it right from your workflow. So you click on edit schedule and you can update the schedule here, and it'll automatically update that schedule that you have set. And then the other thing I wanted to highlight is we've now cached your project list. This table takes a little bit to load sometimes, especially depending on the number of projects you have. And so if you're moving between tabs, coming back to the project list, sometimes it'll take a second to load. But now, as you can see, it loads pretty much instantly. And then in the reports list, some people had a hard time figuring out how to open these correctly. So you could previously click on the metadata and click open report. You could double click on a report, but everybody wanted to open it with a single click. And so we've heard your feedback. And so now you can click one time and it'll open right away. And with a single click, I'm in and I have my report. If you want to look at the metadata, before that was what would happen with a single click. Now you need to simply click on the info icon and that'll open up the metadata here. But anywhere else, if you single click, it will just open the page. Now also here within the reports, we've added some very in-demand projects or reports from Reports and Analytics. And we'll have a separate video going into more detail on these, but that is the next page and previous page reports. So just like an RNA, if you want to view what happens immediately following a specific page, we come with the pre-built page dimension and the dimension item. And then this is next is what I chose. So it's defaulted to next and you can choose your container. And then after you hit build and it loads, now you've got a great project with some high level numbers and a great readout of what happened immediately following after that initial page that you chose. So the same is for previous page, except the builder state is now defaulted to previous. And then the segment that gets applied is the page immediately before that page that's selected. So these are all here by default. Now the other page that we added is the page summary report. So we default to your top page, but you can use the dropdown to change it to any other. You click build. And now you've got a great report with some high-level summary numbers with trended data year over year, month over month, some other high level statistics, and then a default flow report that you can use to explore where people are also going from this page or coming to this page. So really, really quick and great report to analyze a specific page and get you some high level numbers on that. Now, all of these actually function as panels. So if you're in Workspace, you're not on the reports page, you can open up the panel menu and you can see we have next or previous item here as a panel option or the page summary as a panel type. You can use those to start analyzing directly from your project without going back to the reports page if that's what you're interested in doing. So two other things that we've added, many people wanted to access real time and bots from the report section instead of having to go back to reports and analytics. So here we've added real time, you can see, and this will take you to the current real time report and RNA. And then we've also got both of the bot reports on your audience. So we have bots and bot pages. So it'll do the same thing where you can open it up and view it directly in the current experience from reports and analytics without having to log out of the beta. So those are some of the new reports that we've added. And then the last thing that I want to talk about is within customer journey analytics. Previously, when we first launched the beta, it was not available within customer journey analytics or CJA, but with this update, we are making it available within customer journey analytics. So just like before, you'll see it has a toggle option on the bottom. You simply opt into the beta and you'll get the same great landing experience. The only major difference here is that we do not have the reports section because of the way the data is structured in CJA. We don't have a way of knowing any of the pre-built content. That is something we're currently working on. And so we'll have some form of that here in the future. But for now, the report section is not available, but you still have all the great goodness for the projects and the learning here within CJA. And those are all the updates we have for the new landing page. We hope you enjoy. Please continue to provide feedback. That's been super valuable as we continue to make changes as we prepare to make this a full-fledged feature sometime in the future. Thank you.